हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग, हाउ आर यू? एंजॉइंग योर हॉलीडेज? बट नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट सम स्टडी। आई नो ऑल ऑफ यू आर प्रोमोटेड टू क्लास 10th। आई माई सेल्फ एंडी जोशी, योर इंग्लिश टीचर। I am going to explain you the tenses. As you know, there are 12 tenses, but they are divided in 4 parts. Let's study one by one. First of all, we know about indefinite tenses. As we know, indefinite means anischit. The verb which is not clear whether it is completed or not. So it is called indefinite tense, present indefinite, past indefinite and future indefinite. Generally, in present indefinite and future indefinite tense, we use the first form of the verb. In past indefinite tense, in affirmative sentences, we use second form of the verb, and in negative and interrogative sentences, we use first form of the verb. So we can say that in indefinite tense, generally there is the use of first form of the verb. As second tense is continuous tense, which tells us about the work which is going on. There are present continuous tense, past continuous tense and future continuous tense. As we know, continuous tense, we use V1 plus ING as a verb. In all the three tenses, present continuous, past continuous and future continuous. In present continuous tense, we use helping verbs, is, am, are. In past tense, we use helping verbs, was and were. In future continuous tense, we use helping verb, shall be, will be, according to the subjects. The third kind of tense is perfect tense. As it shows, perfect tense indicates towards the work which is fully completed in present, past or future. So in perfect tense we use third form of the verb. And in present perfect tense, we use helping verbs, have or has, according to the subject. In past perfect tense, we use had with all the subjects. In future perfect tense, we use helping verbs, shall have, will have, according to the subjects given in the chart. The fourth kind of tense is perfect continuous tense. There are once again present perfect continuous tense, past perfect continuous tense and future perfect continuous tense. Once again, there is the use of continuous tense, continuous word. So definitely, once again, we will use here V1 plus ING as a verb. And the helping verbs in present perfect continuous tense have been, has been, according to the subjects. In past perfect continuous tense, had been, with all the subjects, and future perfect continuous tense, shall have been, will have been, according to the subjects given in the chart. So as we see that there are total 12 tenses, but generally there is the use of only 4 kinds of verb. In indefinite tense, there is generally we use first form of the verb. Only in past indefinite tense, in affirmative sentence, there is the use of second form of the verb. In continuous tense, we use V1 plus ING. In perfect tense, we use third form of the verb. And once again, perfect continuous tense, we use V1 plus ING. If we conclude this topic, we know there are 12 tenses. They are divided in 4 kinds of tenses. And we use only 4 kinds of verb. V1, V2, V1, V3 and V1 plus ing. Now, I am sending you a chart related to the topic which I explained you just now. Just see this topic, just see the rules and try to do some exercises on all kind of tenses. Goodbye.